Good morning once again. We are on sum number 9 of financial statement of partnership, page number 79. In the previous video, we have finished with trial balance. In this video, we are going to know the effects of adjustments. 6 adjustments are given to us. One by one, we will take all adjustments. And then we will give effects. The first adjustment says provide 8% interest on capital and 12% interest on drawings. What else? Parthiv had withdrawn rupees 400 at the end of each month and Priya had withdrawn entire amount on 1/10/2016. First of all, we will focus on interest on capital, which is to be provided at 8%. Let us see here the capital of Parthiv and Priya are 24,000 and 16,000 respectively. We will calculate 6% interest by interest on capital. We will like this. 24,000 8% 1920, 16,000 8% 1280. Interest of capital, Parthiv 1920, Priya 1280. What it is? Interest on capital. At what rate? 8% per annum. And the second effect of these two will be at the debit side of profit and loss appropriation account. Here it is. To interest on capital, Parthiv and Priya 1920 and 1280, total amount 3200. Now let us talk about drawings. Drawings 12% interest is to be calculated. But what is written? Parthiv had withdrawn rupees 400 at the end of each month. Here we can see the total drawing of Parthiv is 4800. And here it is mentioned he has withdrawn 400 at the end of each month. That means 400 into 12. Every month 400. Total 12 months in a year. So 12 fours are 48. This way it is 4800. Now in the first chapter we have seen that if at the end of every month drawing is made, then the formula is amount of monthly drawing into rate of drawing, that is rate of interest on drawing, into 66 upon 12. First chapter we have learned about it, right? So this way we will calculate 400 every month, this 12% rate, that is 12 upon 100, and total 66 upon 12 months, right? How much is the amount? 264. So the interest on drawing of Parthiv is 264. The same way, here about Priya, it is written that Priya has withdrawn on 1/10/16. Two different partners have withdrawn drawing, means have withdrawn the amount of drawing in different way. One is withdrawing 400 at the end of each month. We have calculated interest. But another partner had withdrawn rupees 3200 and that is one sort. Well, on 1/10/2016. So here from 1/10/2016 to 31/3/2017, 6 months interest will be calculated. Here it is 3200, 12%, 6 upon 12, 6 upon 12 for 6 months. How much it comes? 192. So interest on drawing. One effect here, capital account, as we write drawings at the debit side, interest on drawing is also written at the debit side. We have calculated interest on drawing, Parthiv 264, Priya 192. The second effect of this adjustment at the credit side of profit and loss appropriation account by interest on drawings, Parthiv प्रिया 264 192 टोटल अमाउंट 456। लेट्स मूव टू द सेकेंड एडजस्टमेंट क्रेडिट सेल्स। क्रेडिट सेल्स ऑफ रुपीज 10,000 इज नॉट रिकॉर्डेड एंड टोटल ऑफ सेल्स बुक ऑफ मार्च इज ओवरकास्ट बाय 2,000। टू एडजस्टमेंट, द फर्स्ट वन इज क्रेडिट सेल्स ऑफ रुपीज 10,000 is not recorded. So many adjustment like this we have done in 11th. When this is what? Sales is not written. We will record it. It will be added to sales as well as to debtor. So here we can see unrecorded sales 10,000 will be added to the sales and will also be added to the debtors. Debtors are 48,000 plus unrecorded sales 10,000. After adding that amount, it comes to 58,000. Now, talk about this. Sales book of March is overcast by rupees 2,000. Normally, we have seen all the adjustments are having two effects. But this is adjustment which normally have one effect. The effect will be given to the sales only. Once again, I repeat the adjustment. Sales book of March is overcast by rupees 2,000. This only affects the sales, not debtors. So, if we are having one adjustment of one effect, in that particular sum, we will get another adjustment of one effect. That is for sure. Or else, we will get suspense account. Okay? Either we will get two adjustments, two different adjustments with the same amount which are having one effect. Or what? If we are having only one adjustment which is having one effect, we will be given suspense account. Right? So, here in this sum, we have actually two adjustments with of rupees 2000 which are having one effect. One of them is this, the March sales book is overcast, so that overcast na we have learned in the in final account as well as in rectification of errors. When it is overcast, we have to reverse. That means sales book is overcast, we have to deduct from sales. So here minus sales book overcast rupees 2000. Okay, the next adjustment, additional bad debts of 2000 and provide 5% bad debts reserve. This is additional bad debt, that is bad debts of adjustment and BDR of adjustment. So here in debtors, bad debts minus adjustment 58,000 minus 2000 comes to 56,000, and then BDR at 5%, 56,000 5% of 56,000 comes to 2,800, and after deducting this amount, the final amount is 53,200 in outer column. The another effect of these two, this bad debts and BDR, we very well know where to record profit and loss account debit side in bad debts format. Here it is, bad debts, trial balance, then dash. There is no bad debts of trial balance, so dash. Then bad debts of adjustment, just we have seen 2000 rupees. Then BDR of adjustment, just we have calculated 2800. So it is 2800. And the bad debts reserve of trial balance, there is no bad debts reserve in trial balance. So again dash. So total amount of these two will be 4800. Next adjustment, furniture of rupees 4000 became obsolete, which is not recorded in the books. That means furniture has become of no use. It is total lost. Total loss, that is a loss, and supposed to be deducted from furniture. Furniture, it was 10,000 minus loss of obsolete furniture 4000. Outer column 6000. We have to reduce the amount of furniture and fittings as it has been reduced. That 4000 is of no use. The furniture of 4000 is of no use. So from 10,000 we will bring it to the 6000 by deducting this 4000. And another effect, as it is a loss, it's supposed to be written profit and loss account debit side. So under the heading other expenses and losses, to loss of furniture, yeah, how much? 4000. The next adjustment is a court has finalized claim of rupees 4000 for not meeting agreement to provide goods to a customer. What it is? We could not supply goods to customers, and for that it was a legal matter then, and court has sanctioned a claim of rupees 4000 in favor of customer. We supposed to pay rupees 4000 to customer. Why? Because we could not supply goods according to agreement on time, right? So this is an expense, and as it is not paid yet, so it is a liability too, right? So under other expenses and loss, the court claim to court claim for failure of supply of goods 4000. Another effect, it is a current liability. So here in balance sheet, under current liabilities, claim for failure of supply of goods rupees 4000. Next one, last one, outstanding wages of rupees 2000 recorded to wages account, but outstanding wages account is not recorded in trial balance. This is the another adjustment of rupees 2000 which is having one effect. As we have discussed that there will be at least two adjustments which are having one effect. So here is this, wages of rupees 2000 is added to wages, means it is already added to wages but not recorded in trial balance in wages account. So it will have only one effect, that is what, it is already added to wages, so we don't suppose to add to the wages. We will be writing it at the liability side of balance sheet under current liability. Balance sheet, current liabilities, outstanding wages, rupees 2000. So it was all about our adjustment. There is no hidden adjustment. Sometimes we get, as in the previous sum, we had two hidden adjustment. But here in this sum, we do not have any hidden adjustment. We have finished with all adjustment. Okay.